Version control is kind of hectic in hardware engineering, but we tried to solve this issue by using Git and GitHub, and they seem to work well to a certain level. But this won't be just enough for hardware engineers. Even though we can see the changes and various versions, it's hard to see what's the difference between previous version and current version of the circuit without toggling back and forth. To solve this issue, in this video we'll use CADLAB.io, which lets us see the version difference in real time along with various collaboration and annotation tools. I hope you already have some understanding of how version control works and how to use it. If not, watch these two videos before going forward. Anyway, let's start with signing up for CADLAB.io. Here I'll use the GitHub to sign up, so it'll be a little easier later to integrate CADLAB with existing GitHub repositories. Once logged in, we'll have a demo project with a guide explaining the features of CADLAB along with how to use them. But in our case, we'll try to understand CADLAB interface and features using our custom project. So I'll skip the tutorial and then click on Create Project. Here, let's give the project a name and some description. For ownership, I'll select personal, and for access, I'll select public. Unfortunately, on free version of CADLAB, we have a very limited number of private projects, but it can be upgraded with a paid version. Now, finally, for the repository, I'll skip the first two options and select this because I have already hosted the project on GitHub. Now, to give access to CADLAB to access GitHub repository, click on Authorize. And once the authorization is done, make sure you select the repository that you want to link and then click on Create Project. This page looks very similar to GitHub. On the top, we have the branch selection. We have all the files and folders listed here. And finally, readme file for the project. Now, what makes CADLAB unique is this section, where we can see the PCB layout file, schematic file, and library files without the CAD software that was used to create it. This feature is excellent and allows us to share the file to someone for a quick reference or for a quick review. And yes, this feature not only works for KiCad, but also works with Altium and Eagle as well. Anyway, now let's dive into all the features of CADLAB, starting with branches and history of change. To do that, go to branches. This feature is very similar to GitHub, where we can see all the branches of the project and also commit history of each branch. But CADLAB is unique in showing the changes unlike GitHub. It can show the changes on a visual level with an interactive window to see the changes of the tracks, components, symbols, text, and everything that's related to the project. To open up the visualizer, select any one of the branch and click on Changes. And then click on Visual Changes. This visualizer can be used to see the difference between previous and recent commit without going back and forth between KiCad and Git. Since the CADLAB rebuilds an entire file rather than just taking a snapshot, this lets us access various layers of the PCB without using a CAD software, which is a pretty good feature. Along with this, the visualizer can be used to see the difference between two branches as well. To do that, go to Branches and select the from by using this button and use this button to select the two and then click on Compare and then click on Visual Changes. With this, we can see the various changes that's happening between two different branches. And we can see all the changes that happened during the development under the change list. Now, apart from this feature, we can use the visualizer to mark and annotate for better collaboration. Let me show you a quick example. Let's say we want to change the size of the LED from 5mm to 3mm. I can use the annotation tool and click on annotate, and I can draw an outline around the LED. And then I can add the message that I want to convey for the developers. And once the request is done, you can just click on this icon here. This will resolve the annotation, which means the feature is successfully added to the PCB. Already, this provides a very decent amount of features for version control and visualization. But having visual collaboration pushes CADLAB one step ahead of GitHub for hardware engineers. Unfortunately, there's only so much features that we can use on the free version of CADLAB. If you like to use more features of CADLAB, check out their pricing page, which mentions all the features they'd be providing along with their Pro and Teams plan. Anyway, this completes the KiCad version control series. If you'd like to read more about CADLAB, please check out the article we have written on CADLAB.io. If you like this kind of video, make sure to subscribe to the channel to see more interesting content related to KiCad. And if you have any questions or doubt, please reach out to us at PCBCupid Q&A. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.